Exercise 2.11, question number 2. Evaluate the following integral as the limit of a sum. Integral 1 to 3 x dx. Solution. We have the formula to find the integral of the function f of x from the limit a to b. A is the lower limit, b is the upper limit. Here, lower limit 1, upper limit 3, function is x, f of x and x. Here f of x equal to x, a is equal to 1, b is equal to 3, upper limit 3. Here h is equal to b minus a by n. This is a formula to width of the interval, to find the width of the interval. B minus a, that is 3 minus 1 divided by n. B minus a by n, that is 3 minus 1 by n, 2 by n. H solved. Next, we have the formula integral a to b f of x dx. Limit n tends to infinity, h tends to 0, summation r is equal to 1 to n, h into f of a plus r into h. First, let us solve for a plus rh. What is a? 1, b value 3, h is equal to 2 by n. Next, a plus rh is equal to, what is a? 1, a is equal to 1, plus r into h, h value 2 by n, already solved. Here r into 2 by n, that is 2r by n, as it is 1. Next, f of a plus rh. F of a plus rh value, here substituted 1 plus 2r by n. So, f of a plus rh equal to, what is f of x? F of x is nothing but the original function x. Here, f of 1 plus 2r by n is nothing but 1 plus 2r by n, original. X, f of x equal to x. That is f of 1 plus 2r by n equal to 1 plus 2r by n. Next, this is written again. H into f of a plus rh, h into 1 plus 2r by n. This is substituted here. H is equal to 2 by n. 2 by n, h value substituted. 2 by n multiply into the bracket. 2 by n into 1 plus 2 by n into 2r by n, that is 4r by n square. Summation r is equal to n to 1 to n, h into f of a plus rh. Summation added on both sides. Summation of 2 terms, 2 by n plus 4r by n square. Summation taken into 2 terms. First part, summation 2 by n. Second term, summation 4r by n square. Here written again. Summation r is equal to 1 to n, h into f of a plus rh, 2 by n. Here 2 by n taken out from the summation, 2 by n taken out from the summation. So what is remaining? 1 is remaining. Again 4 by n square taken out from the summation. So summation r only here. Here n terms all are taken out from the summation. Here also n contained term also taken out from the summation. Both terms n taken out. Here 2 by n summation 1. Summation 1 r is equal to 1 to n. It means that 1 is added n times. That is 1 plus 1 plus etc. up to n. So therefore n into 1 is equal to n. N into 1 is equal to n. Here summation 1 r is equal to 1 to n. This is the formula n. 4 by n square as it is in the previous step. Here summation r, what is the formula? Summation r is nothing but the sum of first n natural numbers. Sum of first n natural numbers 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus etc. up to n natural numbers, n terms. So this is nothing but n into n plus 1 by 2, already learned in earlier class. So summation r is n into n plus 1 by 2. Here r is equal to 1 to n, up to n terms added. So it is written again. Here n get cancelled. Here 2 and 4 after cancelling, 2 on numerator. Here n and n square cancelling, n on denominator. Here 2 plus 2 divided by n, n plus 1. 2 plus 2 by n. Here n plus 1 written using the formula idea. Multiplying both n plus 1 numerator and denominator, n divided by n. Here, n is taken out, multiply n numerator and denominator. Numerator multiplied here. Here, denominator multiplied. It means n plus 1 by n. N by n, 1. Here, 1 by n. So, suppose let us verify. N into 1, n plus n into 1 by n, 1. So, n plus 1 can be written using this idea, n into 1 plus 1 by n. Because 1 by infinity, as n tends to infinity, 1 by infinity becomes 0. So, this term get vanished. So, that we are writing this n on numerator can be written using this idea on denominator, n on denominator. Here, n plus 1 can be written using this idea. N is taken out. That is, n is multiplied on both numerator and denominator. It becomes n into 1 plus 1 by n. This n plus 1 written as n into 1 plus 1 by n. Here, n get cancelled. After cancelling, here 2, here is 2. 1 plus 1 by n remains. Here, multiplying. Here, 2 is here. 2 into 1 multiply into the bracket. 2 here, 2 into 1 by n, 2 by n. After adding these 2, 2 plus 2 becomes 4. Here, 4 plus 2 by n. We have the formula to find the integral of the function f of x over the limit a to b. Limit n tends to infinity, h tends to 0, summation r is equal to 1 to n, h into f of a plus r s. Here, already solved these all things. Summation value 4 plus 2 by n. This is substituted here. What is f of x? F of x, x. A value, b values. After substituting these all things, a value substituted 1, b value substituted 3, f of x function x into dx. Limit n tends to infinity, h tends to 0. Here the summation value here solved 4 plus 2 by n. As n tends to infinity, it means that 2 by n is equal to 2 by infinity. When denominator is infinity, the total value tends to 0. So, 2 by n tends to 0. This term tends to 0. So, 4 plus 0. After adding this 4 plus 0, 4. That's all. Next, let us verify. Integral 1 to 3 x dx. X power n formula. X power 1. That is the x power 1 plus 1 by 1 plus 1, x square by 2, limit 1 to 3. So, first upper limit minus lower limit, then lower limit. So, substituting x is equal to 3, it is 3 square by 2 minus lower limit 1 square by 2. X value 3 and 1 substituted, upper limit minus lower limit, upper limit minus lower limit. This is 9 by 2 minus 1 by 2, that is 8 by 2 equal to 4. So, that's all. Thank you.